My name is Nishad, Jayasundara. We started this research that we're doing on kidney health in farming communities with the idea of understanding links between agrochemical exposures and the impact on kidney function. So we do this work in Sri Lanka, and the most important lesson I've learned in working in these communities is that climate change is real for them. They've seen shifts in their farming seasons. In the past, they've been able to predict when to plant their rice seeds so they can get the most optimum harvest. But over the last 20, 25 years, every farmer that I would speak to would suggest that they've seen significant shifts in when they can start harvesting and when they can start planting seeds for the next seasons. So with changes in the climate, we are also beginning to see increased use of pesticides, increasing time spent outdoors, working longer hours, exposed to heat stress for longer, as well as the chemicals staying around for longer that would have negative health outcomes. It could be that heat itself is directly changing how our own cells respond to a chemical or how our own cells respond to another physiological challenge. Or heat stress could directly be affecting our cells in a way that those cells can't repair themselves, or it's damaging certain elements in the cell that might also be affecting kidneys. Heat stress can also cause dehydration, which is also known to induce kidney failure. So both climate change and pollution, two key drivers in current environmental changes, is creating the kidney diseases that we are seeing in these communities. And what I'm hoping is that what we can learn from Sri Lanka will give us a framework to study how environmental change can have negative health outcomes on some of the most poor and also most disadvantaged communities around the world, not just in other countries, but also here in the United States. A lot of this work would not have been possible without both the community we work in as well as the collaborators that I get to work with, especially Professor Mangala De Silva, who's at University of Ruhuna, has been incredible. He's really helped build this research in the country, working with policymakers as well as the community members. And I hope that the research that we are doing, and we've already published and we've already brought attention to the government officials, is going to have a direct change, is going to create a direct change in these communities so they can get access to cleaner water. What gives me hope about this research is that I've been able to work with some communities around the world that I have personal connections to. And what I find is that people are willing to learn and address the impacts of environmental change caused by humans. And it's exciting that, especially when the young people are involved, when the school children are involved in these activities, you see that they know that the earth that they're inheriting or the communities that they're inheriting has to be better, and they're willing to fight for that change. That gives me a lot of hope.